Here is Danny, and today Nvidia has announced their new video cards on a live stream. The new architecture is called Ampere, and Ampere is supposedly better at AI and ray tracing memes, making it, according to the Nvidia boss, up to 2 or 3 times better depending on the task. And because it is not per se about more transistors on the card, it is also more energy efficient, since the cards can use more AI stuff. There will also be RTX IO, which makes stuff loading quicker, basically. The 3080 has a new cooling system, designed that is supposed to be more quiet and efficient. It has 10GB of DDR6X VRAM, and it is going for $700 and drops September 17. The 3070 goes for $500, and it is more powerful than the current 2080 Ti. It has 8GB of DDR6X VRAM and drops somewhere in October. Hey Nvidia, my birthday is the 19th that month, hint hint. And as last, the RTX 3090 is Nvidia's next giant video card that isn't really meant for the mass market. And it is supposedly able to run games like Remedy's Control at 8K 60fps, with its massive 24GB of VRAM, which amounts to a lot of pixels. It also requires multiple slots on your computer, so it won't even fit in mine. Also, just look at the size comparison between the cards, damn! The 3090 goes for $1500 and drops September 24. They sadly did not announce a 3060 just yet, which would be the cheaper version of the Ampere cards. Maybe later down the line, I guess. They also did not announce any versions with a prefix like the supercards or the Ti. And honestly, the pricing seems pretty competitive. No need to sell any body parts for now. Unless you want the 3019, of course, but that card is more intended for people who need that much power for work tasks. Or to flex on their friends, I guess. We all know someone like that. There is also some other announcements that all RTX users can use. For example, Fortnite gets ray tracing and DSLL support for some reason. Nvidia also announced a system called Nvidia Reflex to improve latency in games, coming to games like Apex Legends and other competitive games. They have also announced a 360Hz screen, in which you can plug in your mouse, and Nvidia Broadcast, that can use AI to remove or blur the background, and uses RTX voice for the voice, yes, being able to turn your living room into a studio. It can also follow your head, so if you move your head, it keeps tracking it. Another thing they have is Nvidia Omniforce Machinima, what a name, making it easier for Machinima creators to make cool stuff. Also using AI to use your webcam for basic motion capture. You're also able to use game assets and other libraries to fill in your virtual worlds. They're also showing off different uses for AI, like video to 3D and physics simulation. Black Ops Cold War will support ray tracing, and they showed off a new trailer. They also showed off a Cyberpunk trailer, but hey, that is all I got for now. Subscribe for more, buy my merch so I can get one of those cards. This is Danny, and I see you on a battlefield.